Hey everybody, this is Dylan. Dr. McDougall recently sent out his top 10 tips for maximum weight loss, so I wanted to run through them with you as a summary and add a little bit of commentary along the way. For anyone who doesn't know of Dr. McDougall, check him out. His book, The Starch Solution, changed my life and the lives of many of my loved ones. So it's a very worthwhile read for helping you get on track with your diet and lifestyle. So let's jump into the list. Number one, start each meal with soup, salad, or fruit. All this is calorie density. Remember, there's a chart where we've got on one end the calorie dilute foods, and on the other end the calorie dense foods, and on the light end is non-starchy vegetables, fresh veggies. Those are all around 100 calories per pound. Anything you would find in a salad bar, pretty much. And the idea here is that if you start each meal with calorie dilute foods that are still very high in fiber and take up lots of space, lots of bulk, you'll eat these foods, they'll take up some more space in your stomach than something that was, say, calorie dense, and you won't have eaten very many calories. These are also very nutrient dense foods, so they're really, really healthy to eat, lots of, so it's great to start a meal with those. Fill up as much as you can on these non-starchy vegetables that are only about 100 calories per pound before you move on to the more calorie dense items such as your whole starches that are closer to 500 or 600 calories per pound. Fruit is around 300 calories a pound, so this is kind of in the same category. If you start a meal with some fruit, you'll be getting lots of nutrition and not all that many calories. You'll take up lots of space in your stomach and feel a little bit closer to getting full. And then move on to your starches. The starches make up the bulk of our calories, our energy that we burn day to day. And those are just your beans, rice, quinoa, lentils, split peas, on and on. All of those whole starches. Those are all around 500, 600 calories per pound. And potatoes too are included in that list. Number two, follow the 50-50 plate method for your meals, filling half your plate with non-starchy vegetables and half your plate with minimally processed starches, such as the ones that I just listed, and choose fruit for dessert. The same idea here is really calorie density. So if you've got half your plate full of low calorie density items like the cooked or raw vegetables, non-starchy vegetables, and then half of your plate with the slightly higher calorie density starches such as the potatoes, beans, rice, etc., you will have kind of gotten a nice reasonable mix of calorie density between the two. Lots of fiber, you'll fill up, you'll feel satiated, you'll get lots of energy, and you won't have eaten all that many calories. So that's the idea there. Choose fruit for dessert, low calorie density item, instead of a standard American dessert, which is usually highly sugared, refined carbs, total junk food. So you want to avoid that, especially if your goal is maximum weight loss. Number three, greatly reduce or eliminate added sugars and added salts. This includes gourmet sugars and salts too. If either is troublesome for you, you can eliminate them. What he means by troublesome is if adding a little bit of sugar or salt to your food is causing you to overeat because it makes the food taste richer, then you might have to eliminate them altogether. I still sprinkle on a little bit of salt at the table at times. We don't use very much added sugar, maybe a little bit of maple syrup in our oatmeal. These aren't amounts that for me and my personality or my body aren't causing me to overeat the food. If the sugar and salt a little bit added is causing you to overeat, then you might have to eliminate it altogether. And that's perfectly fine and it's perfectly normal too. The big picture of this is that you're avoiding the refined carbohydrates and the foods that have tons of added sugar, which is really all standard American packaged food that we're getting. Likewise with the sodium, tons of added sodium, and these are causing us to overeat, and it's just bad news for weight loss, that's for sure. Let's move on. Number four, eliminate all animal foods, dairy, meat, eggs, fish, seafood. This is pretty basic. We know that animal products cause cancer, heart disease, high blood pressure, heart attack, stroke, etc. Eliminate them altogether. You don't need them. There's no fiber in them. There's really nothing very healthy at all about them. So just get rid of them. Number five, eliminate all higher fat plant foods such as nuts, seeds, avocados, tofu, soy. They call these overt fats, right? I would also add coconut and olives to the list. They're the foods that are they may be whole foods, but they're higher calorie density foods because they get a large percentage of their calories from fat. So if you're eating a generally healthy diet, practicing a healthy lifestyle, you can eat some of these richer fat foods, such as nuts, seeds, avocado, etc. But if your goal is maximum weight loss, you want to just avoid them altogether. Your goal should be to stick with the foods that are 500 or 600 calories per pound or less. And that's going to achieve the greatest amount of weight loss. So that is the idea there. Number 6, eliminate any added oil. Oil is straight fat. It is 4,000 calories per pound, which is the most calorie dense food that we can eat. Oil causes a lot of the same problems as animal products, such as heightened risk of cardiovascular disease, stroke, heart attack, cancer, etc. You should just avoid it at all costs. One tablespoon of oil is 120 calories, which means if you go about your day eating like normal, but you add one tablespoon of oil every single day, over a 30-day period, you will have added 3,600 calories to your diet. And one pound of fat has been calculated to be right around 3,500 calories. So that means that after a month of eating one tablespoon of oil every single day, you will have added a pound of fat to your body every single month. That's crazy. So obviously you can see why eliminating oil from your diet altogether is the best way to aid your weight loss. Number 7, eliminate all higher calorie dense foods, including flour products, i.e. bread, bagels, muffins, crackers, dry cereals, cookies, cakes, puffed cereals, air popped popcorn, and dried fruit. These are all very calorie dense items. Even if they were whole food-ish, like dried fruit, it's been processed. The liquid's been taken out. So for a pound of dried fruit, you're getting way more calories than a pound of fresh fruit. Same goes for popcorn, it's dried. Same goes for puffed cereal. The liquid has all been taken out of the corn, say, in a puffed corn cereal. So you're getting a lot more calories per pound when you're eating those kinds of items. Bread is like 2,500 calories per pound. Even if it's whole wheat bread, it's very much more calorie dense than, say, eating whole starches. So you want to avoid those kinds of calorie dense foods. And that isn't even talking about refined carbohydrates, such as packaged processed food, like we buy, you know, just junk food, processed white flour products, etc. All that obviously must be avoided if your goal is maximum weight loss. Number 8, don't drink your calories, especially from juices and sugar sweetened beverages and smoothies, right? If you take fresh fruit, freeze it, blend it up, and then chug it down, you're going to get a lot more calories much more quickly than if you'd just eaten some fresh fruit to begin with. So you're kind of tricking your body when you're drinking your calories. You're able to drink a lot more calories because you're not chewing and swallowing and all these things. You're not taking up as much bulk. So you want to make sure that you're eating your whole food rather than blending up your smoothies or juicing or whatever. Green smoothies are obviously a little bit better than fruit smoothies, but they're still concentrated calories. So the best bet would be to eliminate them altogether. Eat them as whole foods where they're still 100 to 300 calories per pound, rather than as smoothies, which are much richer. Okay, number 9, follow these principles, eating whenever you are hungry until you are comfortably full. Don't starve yourself and don't stuff yourself. The idea here is that if you follow all the principles we've already gone through, you'll be eating the right food. Now, if you just eat till you're comfortably full, you're gonna be in really good shape. You don't have to count your calories in order to ensure that you're eating the right amount of food. You don't have to feel deprived like so many diets make you feel because you can only eat so many bites of this stuff that's super calorie dense compared to these other things. You can just eat comfortably. And if you stage your eating, like we talked about at the beginning, with eating soup, salads, and fruit first, and then following that with the higher calorie dense foods like whole starches, which are only 500 or 600 calories per pound, you're going to be getting full right after you've eaten just the perfect amount of calories to maintain a healthy weight, or to lose weight in the case of maximum weight loss. Number 10, avoid being sedentary and aim for at least 30 minutes or more of moderate exercise daily, i.e. brisk walking. I've talked about this in a few other videos. The idea here is that you don't want to be sedentary because then you won't be burning your maximum potential of daily calorie burn. but you also don't need to do 2 hours of mountain climbing in order to maintain a healthy weight. If you're eating the right food and you're burning your maximum average calories per day that your body is able to burn, then you're going to be in good shape. It turns out that if you do 30 minutes of brisk walking or 60 minutes of brisk walking, you're still going to have burned right around the same amount of calories. But if you do 0 minutes of walking compared to 30, you'll probably be under your maximum calorie burn potential for the day. So you want to get at least to your maximum calorie burn, and then you really don't need to do a whole lot more. We've grown up thinking that weight loss comes from working your butt off in the gym, and it really doesn't. I proved when I lost 25 pounds that doing absolutely no exercise, that weight loss comes from eating the right food. And nobody's really talking about that except us. So you have to ensure that you're getting your moderate amount of exercise, you're staying active, but you don't need to kill yourself in the gym to try to lose weight. That is a relief for a lot of people that are working on a maximum weight loss plan like this one. So I hope that makes you feel better. Anyway, that is the top 10 tips from Dr. McDougall. Check out his book. I will put a link in the description. See you on the next video. Thanks for watching. Take care.